One of the biggest crimes in science for the last 150 years is the falsification of the Mendeleev's periodic table. For more than a century, scientists have relied on the periodic table to classify and understand the elements of our universe. However, there is a hidden story behind the famous table that has been deliberately kept in secret. What is that truth, and are we finally ready to accept it? We will try to find out together in the new episode of Secret Origins. Welcome. The truth is that the original periodic table created by the Russian scientists Dmitri Mendeleev in 1905 included a mysterious chemical element called ether. This element was considered the smallest of all other elements and was believed to be the key to understanding the connection between matter and energy. However, after Mendeleev's death, world academic science manipulated the table and eliminated the ether, which allowed for the creation of the theory of relativity. Today, this mysterious element is known as Newtonium, and its discovery could revolutionize our understanding of the universe. It is not a question of substitution or incorrect arrangement of chemical groups, but of a deletion of a single but very important, unstudied and deliberately kept secret chemical element called ether. It's the smallest of all, smaller than molecules and part of the base from which atoms are derived. The Russian scientists published the very original of the periodic table in 1905 in the textbook Fundamentals of Chemistry. There, in group 0, along with the inert gases we know, helium, neon, krypton, and xenon, Mendeleev placed ether. But who was he? Who was Dmitri Mendeleev? Mendeleev was the first to arrange the chemical elements according to regularity, and his idea is so insightful that we are even used to calling the periodic system of chemical elements Mendeleev's table. This Russian scientist, encyclopedist, Dmitri Mendeleev was born on February 8, 1834. In Tobolsk, Western Siberia. His research interests have not only been in the field of chemistry. Mendeleev was also involved in physics, mineralogy, meteorology, economics, technology. He was the author of a number of fundamental studies in these areas. Do we know how he came to invent the periodic table? By the mid-19th century, 63 chemical elements had been discovered. Mendeleev, like other scientists of his era, sought some unifying scheme to connect them. According to a legend, the scientist tried to solve this problem by arranging cards on which he had written the names of the 63 known elements along with their atomic weights and tried to arrange them into groups. But he didn't feel like it. He got tired and fell asleep. And it was in a dream that he saw the solution. However, great discoveries still do not come without effort, but rather are a result of hard work. Based on the vast amount of factual information he gathered about the specific gravities and composition of silicon compounds, Mendeleev arrived at broader concepts, the concept of an element's place in the periodic table as a combination of its properties compared to the properties of other elements, the quantitative ratios of its mass, and the characteristics of the substance. So, what exactly was this mysterious element that Mendeleev placed at the beginning of the periodic table? He called it Newtonium in honor of the great Isaac Newton. It was he who claimed that the entire space of the universe consists of an elusive gas without which the existence of anything is impossible. Mendeleev also believed that ether was the connecting part of chemistry and physics and a basic building block. At the end of the 19th century, the Russian was one of the last world-famous scientists who defended the idea that the Newtonian, ether, is the substance from which the universe is built, and in it is the key to unraveling it. Nowadays, the name Newtonium is used as the working name for an as yet undiscovered element with atomic number 119. Its symbol, NW, and it appears in the scientific literature as Unonium or element 119. In the periodic table, it should be the 7th alkali metal and the first element of the 8th period. Unonium is silvery liquid metal at 25 degrees but freezes at 20 degrees Celsius. Scientifically speaking, Newtonium is practically not found on Earth. This element can only be synthesized naturally by the largest supernova or massive neutron star collisions because it requires a huge amount of energy to make it. The calculated amount of Newtonium in the entire universe is this. Kilograms, which is equal to half the mass of Jupiter. After the death of Mendeleev, the periodic law was deliberately edited by world academic science. The removal of the ether, the change in which the inert gases are united with the elements of the 8th group, and the table assumes that the form in which it is now studied. The elimination of the ether allowed Einstein, borrowing the ideas of Henri Poincaré, to create and impose the theory of relativity. Physicists abandoned the concept of ether and recognized the electromagnetic field as a self-sufficient object that does not need an additional carrier. By accepting this thesis, scientists gave priority and a leading role to matter. Thus, the connection between physical and implicit order is excluded, and men of science consider only the material substance. From the point of view of the whole, from one more global perspective, from the perspective of all there is, this is only a half understanding. The last time the real table saw the light of day was in 1906 in the textbook Fundamentals of Chemistry, and 96 years later, it rose from the ashes thanks to the publication of the Russian Physical Society's magazine. The main distortion of the table is the transfer of the zero group to its end to the right and the introduction of so-called periods. Such a seemingly harmless manipulation can be logically explained by a conscious removal of the main link in Mendeleev's discovery. Mendeleev writes, "Let's mentally approach this important, therefore the fastest moving element X, which according to my view can be considered ether. I wish in advance to call it Newtonian in honor of the immortal Newton. The problem of attraction and the problem of all energy can have no real solution without a real understanding of the ether as a universal medium transmitting energy at a distance. A true understanding of the ether cannot be attained by ignoring its chemistry and not considering it an elemental substance." In the 19th century, the concept of the world ether had a huge impact. The scientists of that time reasoned like this. Since sound waves need a medium to propagate, air, liquid, or a solid body, there should be a material medium in which light waves can be transmitted. And for such a medium was chosen the ether, which fills all space and carries light, heat, and gravity. Scientists have studied highly rare field gases to prove the existence of the ghostly substance. Mendeleev also tried by diluting the air to reach some gas with very small weight so that the properties of ordinary substances would no longer overlap the properties of ether. In an appendix to the textbook Fundamentals of Chemistry on the Periodic Table, Mendeleev wrote in 1871, "The lightest of all, millions of times, is the ether." And in 1874, in a workbook, the scientist was even more categorical. "At zero pressure in the air, there is some density, and that is the ether." Nowadays, academic Alexei Yuryevich Zolotarev is taking on the task of rehabilitating the original Mendeleev's table. Unwillingly has the support of a very powerful ally. It is interesting enough that Stalin himself ordered the primitive version of the table to be displayed as a wall mosaic in the Leningrad Museum. This happens in 1935, and there the Zero Group is present. At the same time, however, it is expressed in textbooks. For the existence of the ether, Zolotarev also refers to the discoveries of the brilliant scientist Nikola Tesla. In 1892, he constructed a resonance transformer, obtaining at the output an energy many times greater than that at the input. When journalists ask him how this is possible, he answers, "I capture energy from the ether and transform it into electricity." Tesla goes even further, finding a way to transmit electrical energy without wires, directly through the air itself. After the newspapers of the time were buzzing about his sensational experiments, suddenly the discoverer's practices became conspiracy, and his name became a taboo for the media. Having created more than 1,000 inventions and more than 800 patents, Nikola Tesla died in a hotel room, alone, poor, in debt. According to some theories, his notes were seized and classified because at a time when oil was becoming a staple of booming economies, the creation of a cheap alternative would disrupt the emerging world order. This is by no means accepted by both the traditional academic community and the financial elite that funded it. In the end, the concept of ether was erased from physics, and science was pushed in another direction by the helpful theory of relativity, in which space and time are mixed. The great mysteries surrounding the altered Mendeleev table also provide food for the researchers of the transcendental and the occult. What is air? According to them, this is the energy that the body releases after death. American psychologist John Kachuba, in his book Ghostbusters, uses the laws of physics to point out that the energy in the universe is constant and cannot be destroyed, but all space is filled with an invisible substance called ether. The American believes that this is exactly the energy that is released from the body after a person's death. Jerry Vassilatos, in The Lost Discoveries, deals with the Victorian scientists who wanted to prove that there is a substance that filled all space and matter. They called it ether and gave it a divine origin. Skeptics, on the other hand, find ethereal tales really airy and join the forbidden physics theory to pseudoscience. According to Einstein's staunch supporters, the sensational opinions about the existence of a such small particle are untenable. Was Mendeleev right about the existence of the ether? Is this the substance of the energy surrounding us? If it really exists, can we imagine the significance of the great discovery made by Mendeleev all those years ago? The proof of ether and its significance to both chemistry and physics can open up a new realm of understanding and possibilities. The world may never know why the truth was hidden for so long, but what is clear is that the legacy of Mendeleev lives on, and his contribution to science will never be forgotten. The pursuit of knowledge never stops, and we believe that with each new discovery, the mysteries of the universe are slowly but surely uncovered. We bow before you and thank you for watching another episode of Secret Origins. Keep your minds open, and until we meet again.